Welcome to the program of Department of Library and Information Science, University of Calcutta. We have completed 75 years of our journey through the education space of Library and Information Science. But due to this pandemic situation, we couldn't observe or celebrate this glorious journey due to this pandemic situation. Hence, we are trying now to have this monthly lecture series to celebrate the completion of 75 years of our journey. We already had few lectures arranged by our department, and in each lecture, important people from our country and abroad have taken part to share their views and their experiences to our students, scholars, teachers, and to the audiences beyond the boundaries of our great institution. Today, we have another lecture program. We are proud to have two of the luminaries of LIS scenario. We have Dr. Momaini from Iran. She is associate professor in ATU University, Iran. She is also heading the research department. Her research department is involved in interdisciplinary studies in research. Now I welcome you, Madam Momaini, Madam, to deliver your lecture. We will share the PPT just in 1 minute.
Lecture, ma'am.
Just 1 second. We are just loading the PPT, madam. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. And madam, when you complete the first page, please say next. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. May I start, Susmita ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Professor
start.
Susmita ma'am. Okay. With respect. First of all, I would like to thank Professor Susmita Chakraborty. She is my friend and colleague. And I thank Professor Aravinda Mehti and the organizing meeting. And I'm very pleased with the speaker, with Professor Manju Kumar Sina. A special thank to the Vice Chancellor of Calcutta University, Professor Sunil Chakravarti Vanriji, and other associate in this lecture. My name is Ismat Momaini. Right now, I am teaching in Allameh Tabatabai University, Tehran, Iran. It is my pleasure, I am with you on series to celebrate glorious 75 years Calcutta University in India. Today is 28 September 2021. The topic of my lecture is research ethics and plagiarism. Prevention. For doing what I'm saying. earning a serious warning, part one, ethics, and part two, research, part three, ethic in research, principle of research ethics, and also example of immoral research behavior. And part four, plagiarism and its causes, such as the cultural factor, training factor, and educational factor, social factor, and economic factor. And the end of my lecture, I'm going to conclusion requirements and competencies of research ethics. Now, in this slide, I'm showing a serious warning. You know, individual health plus community health equal promoting desirable research behavior. Otherwise, come out.
Excuse me, ma'am. Please tell us when we have to change the slide. Okay. Next.
Okay. Right. Okay.
Okay.
I'm telling at first. Yes, I'm going a speech format. First of all, earning a serious warning. Part one, ethics. Part two, research. Part three, ethics in research, including principle of research ethics, and also example of immoral research behavior. And part four, plagiarism and its causes, such as a cultural factor, training factor, educational factor, and social factor, and so economic factor. And the end of my lecture, I'm going to conclusion, requirement, and competencies of research ethics. Next slide, please. Next slide. Ma'am, if you go to next slide, please. Yes. Earning. The previous slide, ma'am. Previous earnings. I'm telling a serious warning. You know, individual health plus community health equal promoting desirable research behavior. Otherwise, come up plagiarism. The next slide, ma'am. Excuse me, Professor Susmita. Next slide. Part one, ethics. What's the meaning of ethics? Ethics simply means knowing the right from the wrong. Ethics reflects the inner state. You know, if the origin is repeated, it will be treated. Ethics requires the education of the individual, then the necessary social context. This point is very important. I am telling and explain the other slide why this point is very important. Training required the following replay, cognition, innovation, motivation, and skill. Please, next slide. Part two, what is the meaning of research? Research is a step that researchers set out to clarify a problem in order to find an accurate and logical answer to solve it. The researcher seeks to discover the truth and publish honestly. As a result, research plays a vital role in the destiny of human societies and provide the basis for the development of knowledge. And next slide, part three. What is the ethics in research? Ethics in research means knowing, believing, and acting on a set of ethical norms, do and do nots. Before conducting research, during the research, and after conducted research. As a result, we know ethics in research refers to ethical principles that control and guide research from the first stage to the end of the work and the publication of the work. And we are asking, what do we expect from research ethics? And the other slide, ma'am, next slide. Next slide, yes. In this slide, I am answer the question, every human being is a human being and also a purposeful being needed. Knowing is the principle that addresses the purpose of human life and efficient life. Our expectations of research ethics, building trust and validation of research finding, otherwise ignoring it will lead to a decline in scientific credibility. Next slide. Now, what is the principle of research ethics? As we know, because we are a researcher also in universities and any atmosphere of research, we know honesty and integrity, realism and reasoning, commitment, accuracy, justly use of opportunities, intellectual property, reliability. It's a principle of research ethics. Now, I'm asking, and what force can determine or change the ethical principle of research? Because from this country, with your country, the principle of research ethics is different. I am just asking to myself, what force can determine or change the ethical principle of research? Analyzes of positions, power relations, and forces involved with both religious and traditional approaches is of a particular importance in determining and changing principle. This point also is very, very important. And next slide. Right. Example of immoral research behavior. As you just now and see it, this slide, some of the immoral research behavior example, you can see like basic analysis and interpretation, bias analysis and interpretation, exchange, falsification, topic building in a state of a problem solving, plagiarism, fabrication, and wrong citation, violation of the right of a research colleagues, research contribution, research work again, deal, self-expertise, research rent seeking, use the name and the reputation of others, lack of a loyalty to content of the research proposal, research magnification, deception in providing research tools, lack of approval by the ethics committee, failure to registration clinical trial in the national clinical trials registration system, lack of a transparency or non-disclosure of any conflict between the presenter and colleagues. Next slide. Now, part four, we are going with causes of plagiarism. Using the product and the scientific innovation of another without mentioning the source and the permission from them. Another thing, presenting another idea or finding as a new and initial case. And another thing is using other people's thoughts or expressions without permission and presenting them as your main finding. And end of that, stealing and tricking others into presenting idea and writing in their own name. Next slide, please. In this slide, we are going to cultural factor affecting plagiarism. As a weakness of a moral value, convenience, lack of interest and the motivation, relationships in a state of principle and the rule, and weak faith. Maybe you are asking, what is the meaning of that? All of these depend to cultural aspect. As a if the effect of the weakness of a moral values in the cultural, it comes up plagiarism. Choose the easiest task and the at least and the least effort to get the best score. And also, as you know, lack of a principle phase leads to immoral scientific commission. And another factors also, it comes other slide. Please, next slide, ma'am. Yes, training factor of a plagiarism. Lack of a sufficient expertise is another factor, training factor. Lack of sufficient information and necessary expertise. Unawareness of a relevant law, ignorance of a method to avoid fraud and plagiarism. Weaknesses in the writing. People who do not have the ability to write and the nature, the story, inevitably initiate the article of order. Another slide, ma'am. Another factor is important to plagiarism, the educational, because we are in this atmosphere, the educational factor of plagiarism. Education-oriented school and university. Most of the country, like maybe as my just knowing and research in this my country, the country education system is mostly based on education, and education and research in the school and in university are ignored, unfortunately. And other things, pay attention to quantity in a state of quality. In this slide also, I'm showing such as a factor, educational factor, like insufficient education and information, lack of adequate training, and lack of classes and educational and information workshop. And coercion in research, it is a factor that leads people to commit often, says. And also time maybe comes of plagiarism. The researcher is forced to use a principal method due to the lack of time. Another slide, ma'am, next slide. Yes. Social factor. Next slide, Professor, yes. Social factors affecting plagiarism. Lack of adequate control and supervision means lack of adequate control and supervision in conference and seminar, in dissertation. We face to this so much things. Lack of up-to-date rules due to new problem in the field of intellectual property. And inadequacy of the criminal justice system, it will not be taken as seriously as it should be. And other things, formation of wrong patterns, like committing some kind of scientific misconduct in society. Another factor, next slide. Please, next slide, yes. The economic factor of plagiarism. Utilitarianism in science, doing research, etc., by individual and company in exchange for money. Another factor, lack of budget or facilities, admission of students to the university regardless of the available facilities. And another factor, advances in tool and technology. Maybe in such a country, widespread access has opened up new avenue for plagiarism. We are going to conclusion. Requirement and competencies of research ethics. Prevention is better than cure. Finding the root of an error and preventing it from occurring is the best way to combat it. Another next slide, ma'am. Next slide. Excuse me, ma'am. Next slide. Yes. Factors affecting the prevention of plagiarism. No. Previous slide, ma'am. Previous. Please, previous slide. Yes. Factor affecting the prevention of plagiarism. It's important things in my lecture. Awareness necessary legislation. We should be now a legislation. Remove pressure, ceiling for presentation or completion of the project at a certain time. We should be remove pressure. use and employment of experienced people in the required specialties, awareness of the consequence of plagiarism also. Another slide. It's not sure.
Just one moment.
Okay, right now. Yes. Factors affecting the root. The next slide, ma'am. The next slide, yes. Yes, factors affecting the root of the error and the reasons for distrusting the research finding: fraud, distortion, forgery, manipulation, fake data, and other things, lack of legal supervision necessary to conduct the research, another thing, disclosure of a confidential information, another things, lack of a publishing permission from research sponsors, and another things, lack of necessary satisfaction from the research community, and plagiarism, frequent publication, and end of that, these non-compliance with the copyright and the legal matter. And next slide, I'm going to thankful for your attention. And thank you for your invitation by Professor Susmita Chakraborty and also official of Calcutta University. This is my email, momeni.ismat@sanyahu.com. And Telma and myself and WhatsApp 0098+0937510-7763. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. We are really thankful for having such a learned oratory from your part. And also, Iran and India, both countries start with I. So I want to namaskar you, the welcome address by Indian people.
Thank you, ma'am.
Great persons. Namaskar, madam. Okay.
Namaskar, ma'am. Namaskar.
I will now request Manoj Kumar Sinha to give his deliberation. Before that, I will want to say a few words about him. Professor Manoj Kumar Sinha, as we know, is a very well-known person. He is the professor and head, as well as dean of faculties of the university, Assam University, which is a central university in India. It is in Northeast India. And he acted also as the librarian of Rabindra Library, which is the university library. He has acted as acting librarian of that library. He is a renowned scholar. He has association with so many professional organizations here and from international organizations. He has connections with them also. He has nurtured many research scholars and MPhil students. And he has a wide range of publications, more than 300. And the uniqueness of them is those publications are not only in the field of library information science, but also in the field of geology, botany, as well as environmental science. And last but not the least, he possesses a PhD degree in geology as well as in library and information science. Welcome to our talk, sir. We are really very, very thankful for having you here to deliver your lecture. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, madam, for inviting me for your lecture series. To begin with, Honorable Chief Patron and Honorable Vice Chancellor, Calcutta University, Professor Sonali Chakraborty Banerjee, madam. Professor Ashish Kumar Bandopadhyay, Pro Vice Chancellor. Professor Meenakshi Ray, Pro Vice Chancellor of Business Affairs and Finance. and Professor Devasis Das, Registrar, Calcutta University, and respected Professor Susmita Chakravarti, organizer of the event and Professor and Head, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Kolkata, and all the members of organizing committee, Professor Arvind Methi and Professor Swapna Banerjee, Professor Biplav Chakravarti, Professor Piyush Kanti Panigrahi, Dr. Sabuj Kumar Chaudhary, Dr. Parikshit Mandal, Dr. Bijan Kumar Rai, Dr. Kuvalika Bhattacharya Maitra, and Ms. Nikita Lama. Thank you so much. At the outset, I would like to extend my sincere thanks to all the members of organizing committee for giving me this opportunity to present my presentation before you. So now I will share my presentation. So please inform me that whether my screen is visible or not.
Sir, not yet. Yes.
Now it is coming?
Yeah, yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So my topic of presentation is role of libraries in enhancing research visibility of faculty members and research scholars and supporting research activity. So this is our program. And we know that India is a vast country having 1,500 plus university. And these universities are under University Grants Commission, under Ministry of Education, Government of India. This is the current statistics. You can see we have 437 state university, 126 deemed to be university, 54 central universities, and 388 private university. This picture is up to 6 August 2021. I think some more universities have increased, I think 1,035 up to this date. So there are main objective and function of any higher educational institution is to provide intellectual and managerial leadership to various fields of government, industry, health, engineering, law, defense, education, agriculture, and imbue them with a sense of social purpose, to train a band of research worker in all area mentioned above, to conserve knowledge and ideas for posterity, to foster the ideals of social justice, religious tolerance, national integration among its diverse group of people. We have some important function of higher educational institutions like teaching and learning, research and discovery of new knowledge, dissemination of knowledge, extension of outreach activity, preservation of knowledge for posterity, and our library, central library, learning resource center, they support the aims and objectives, vision, mission of the university for accomplishment of the goal of the university and take it to the higher level of excellence. So here the role of college or university library comes into picture. They are supporting the academic and research activity of the university. And you all know that library is the heart of any educational institution, and all academic activities revolve around it. So there are main objective and function of university library is to development of a collection in a wide variety of subjects for learning, teaching, research, publication, getting the stock of knowledge material, organize and maintain for use, organize and provide a variety of library documentation and information services, both responsive and anticipatory. So we all know our user communities are student, research scholar, faculty member, officer, and staff of the university. So in India, we have ranking system of our institution. And for ranking of the institution, these are some factors which they consider while going for ranking. So there are three or four bodies are there: NAC, National Assessment and Accreditation Center, Bangalore, National Board of Accreditation for Engineering and Technical Institutions, Times ranking of higher educational institution and one recent NIRF, National Institutional Ranking Framework. So you can see the screenshot of the NAC. And recently, India ranking 2020-21 announced by the government of Ministry of Education, Government of India, and all under overall university engineering, different group rankings are made. And the perception of parameters for ranking is teaching learning and resources, research and performance practice, graduation outcome, outreach, and inclusivity and perception of users. So now directly come to the research visibility of faculty members and research scholar and what role library plays. So university or college library, they play an important role in supporting the teaching learning activity. They try to develop adequate library collection, develop state of the art library with application of emerging technologies, making provision for remote access facility during this pandemic period when our universities are physically closed and we are working from home, and university libraries, they are trying to provide us all the resources through remote access facility. Many universities have enabled all such facility, developing institutional repository to showcase the intellectual output of the college university, making faculty and researcher aware about importance of impact factor. So Scopus, Wave of Science, Digital Journal, awareness of available offline. So all these role library play, and making faculty members and research scholar about the predatory journals, plagiarism, etc., open access resources, helping faculty members and scholar to use anti-plagiarism software like Urkun, Turnitin, Grammarly, and many other open source platform. In university, we are providing Urkun software for plagiarism check. Make faculty and they play a wide range of services for the library user. So for a ranking of any university, the research and publication performance of the faculty member is also one of the parameter. So we have seven NAC assessment criteria for accreditation: curricular aspect, teaching learning and evaluation, research consultancy and extension, infrastructure and learning resource, student support and progression, governance, leadership and management, innovation and best practices. So library play one important part, and also they promote the teaching learning affairs and research activity. As a faculty member, we have some responsibility to make our publications visible at different platforms so that people across the world, they can access the resources. We have many commercial and open access model for publication of research paper in scholarly peer-reviewed journal. Commercial journal do not give us access to their publication as they are doing business for profit. If we publish our paper in open access platform journals, our publication will be more visible and it will reach a good number of audience and researcher. So open access movement support for providing access to scholarly publications among the faculty members, researcher and scientists. So why we should make our profile and the research output visible? Because if we make profile on different social media, academic social media platform, we will keep our preprint on that. And in this way, it will be visible to across the world. So earlier we had different resources, printed resources. Now internet and social media came into picture, and they have done a lot. We are not, now we will be not able to stay a minute without internet connectivity. So 4.33 billion people, this is old statistics, and it is a rise of mobile traffic and current mobile traffic there. You can see up to 2019 data is there. 4.79 billion people use the internet worldwide. So there are, in 1 minute, how many activities are performing on internet, you can see. And we use the internet for a wide range of activities day to day. So there are some popular social media platform, and some online teaching learning platform we use. And library help us to understand this platform, make us aware, and help us to open our account on this platform. So one study was conducted, 10 most secure social media platform is Telegram is at number one, followed by WhatsApp. This is monthly uses. Now, when our social media or internet were not there, then we used to have abstracting and indexing journals and in printed format. And these are some abstracting and indexing journals. Some online and abstracting and indexing journals are also available. Now, we are using academic social media extensively now. We have academic social media like ResearchGate, Academia, Figshare, Mendeley, LinkedIn, SlideShare, Speakers Deck. There are so many. One study was conducted and it shows that the remarkable reach of the social media for science and engineering and social science arts humanities people. So I will focus on the creation of profile and academic social media. Since time is less, so I will try to wind up as early as possible. We have many academic social media platform or identification sites like Google Scholar, LinkedIn, under this slides here, academia.edu, ResearchGate, Social Science Research Network. And these are some identification sites, Orchid ID, Pavlon, Researcher ID, Irons of InfibNet, Vidwan database. Earlier, Vidwan database was there. Now it has been changed into Irons of InfibNet, Microsoft Academic Identity. So I will share my own experience. I have created my account in all these sites, and I will show the screenshot of that. It helps me to make our publication visible across the world, and people are accessing it. They are downloading, they are using. So Google Scholar is one of the most important common indexing site you can see. And it is those who are having Gmail account, they can open the site. There are a lot of features on Google Scholar. So you can see my profile on Google Scholar. And I have listed most of the papers in this site. And you can see the citations are also coming. And the H index, I index, you can see. So paper you can list. This is a profile of Dr. Manoj Kumar Verma from Mizoram University. Dr. Madhusudan from Delhi University. Professor Sanjay Kumar Singh from Guwahati University, Madam Susmita Chakravarti from our host of today's program. And ResearchGate profile is also one of the site as academic social media. You can open your site on that. All research scholar faculty members should make their profile, and on the basis of your interaction with the community, you are given the RG score. That is, you can see my score is 16.04, and you can upload your paper and people will access, they can interact with you, and they also give us total research interest, citations, total number of reads, recommendations. So all this make visible your work across the world. I have uploaded some of the paper on this site. You can see the statistics also weekly, or overall statistics you can see, RG score you can see. My friend Manoj Kumar Verma also, he has created. Then another site is Academia, where we can also keep our publications for access to across the world. So I have also created profile on this, and I request all the faculty and the scholar, those who have not created, they can create their profile and they can keep their publications on that. I have kept some of the publication on this site, you can see. My statistics, you can see 30 days or 60 days, how many people have visited your profile, what are the impact of paper, CV, etc. So all unique visitor, you can see download, views, how many countries seen your site, cities, university, etc. All details are coming and you can see. So you can see the user activity, and internationally your paper is visible to different countries like India, Nigeria, Uganda, Pakistan, Tanzania, all countries people are visiting your site and accessing your publications. So these are the some statistics you can see. Then LinkedIn is another site where we professional are creating our profile and making our communication among the professionals. I have also created. And under this, we have slide share platform. Whatever slide you have prepared, you can share your slide in this platform. People will see, download, go through it. In this way, your visibility will be increased. Then another thing is Google. Using Google blogs, you can also showcase for your departmental or your own profile publication in this platform. When I was in library in 2007, when just it started, at that time I created this service with Smile, and still I am maintaining some time. And for department also I created profile. So there are different authors identification site, because with one name there may be many people, and who are you, people don't know, so there may be confusion. So in scientific field, there is a provision for authors identification. So there is a site for social science scholar, social science research network, SSRN. Here also, this is the main page. You can create your login, create your account, and keep your publication on this. I have also created account. You can see the download and the ranking. And this is my page, publication page, and you can see it has 639,984 authors listed in this site, and my rank is 26,311. That depends on how much papers download during the year or per month data they are also sending to us. So papers are listed. In this way, your paper will be visible. Any people can see and download. You can see the status of download here. And there is another ORCID ID. Here you also create, and you can keep your paper. When you write any paper, you can give this ID to your address affiliation, and people will with this they would be able to identify you. There will be a QR code you can also create with your ID, and if you scan it, my profile will open. It also takes publications from online platform. And you can also manually, you can also put in this site. There is another site, Microsoft Academic. You can also create your profile in this. This is a very good platform. I have also created my account here and kept some of my paper in this account. You can see. And another site is Wave of Science Pavlon. So it is very important site when you do any review work. Your review work is listed in this site. You can also keep your publication on that, and it will give you citation, how many papers are cited there. And one important site that recently I come across, that is Figshare. So you can store, share, discover your research, and it allow publishers to visualize and host large amount of data in their article. So you can store your data, research data management you can do using this Figshare. And all these bigger companies, publishers are member of this site. These are some key benefits. So whatever data you keep, if anybody use your data, they will give you credit and they will acknowledge your work. So in this way, your work will be visible, and you can also increase the name of your just I have put one of my record here. Then Vidwan database in Flipnet Center, they have created one expert database early 90s. And then this database has been converted into IRINS. I will show you. So these are some objective of Vidwan database. This is the website, web page. You can see, you can visit the Flipnet site and you will find detail. So who can join? Awardees, postgraduate professor can join. And these are publications are there, and this profile will look like this. You can keep your publication. This is Professor Rath, from Mizoram University. Now this Vidwan database, they merge into this newly formed Indian Research Information Network System. It is like a research gate or academia which are prepared by other country, but in India, Infibnet has taken initiative and make this and all Vidwan data merge into this IRIN site. Details are there in Infibnet website. You can search and have a look. I have also created my profile here. And you can see if you publish paper, you have many co-authors. So how it looks like your work. So you can see in this. And it has one facility that all academic identity you can put here. If you put any paper at any place, they will retrieve paper and add in your site. So these facilities they have enabled. Institutional repository, we all know. And it is a new concept for collecting, managing, disseminating, and preserving scholarly communication. So we can also create for our university library to showcase our intellectual asset before the world. People across the world, they can access your things. You may keep Assam University also created one institutional digital repository. And we have very important National Digital Library of India located in Kharagpur, West Bengal. And it is a project under Ministry of Education, Government of India, and NIIT Kharagpur, Professor P.P. Das, he is the principal investigator. And during this COVID pandemic, they have especially made an interface for all the study at home. You can see COVID-19 research repository, featured collection, all they have kept for school, engineering, science, humanities, literature, all subjects they have covered. This is a very important site, a digital library, and you can get all required material. If you inform your user, they can definitely get benefit from this site. And any thing you can search here, I have searched institutional repository, and you can see the paper are retrieved from any institutional repository across country or world. So I have uploaded my paper in Infibnet institutional repository. So from digital library, this NDLI, we can access it. And you can download it. We have many reference management tools through which we can also manage our papers, and it helps us managing our research data. It is helping in review of literature and writing the bibliography. So a lot of things are there. For detail, we required separate session for that. And Mendeley is important site. I have created my account. And also Zotero is another similar site where we may also create. And when you put your paper, it will look like this. So very interesting. So we can conclude with this. Present time is the age of internet and social media. We are well aware of the use of popular social media platform like Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, Telegram, YouTube, and many more. Many LIS professionals and academicians have been using academic social media platform for showcasing their research publication for sharing among the fellow researcher. The young professionals are dynamic and also well aware in using social media platform. So universities and institutions of higher learning are ranked on the basis of 5 component as mentioned in NRIF ranking. NAC is also doing. So this, if you keep your publication on these media, definitely it will help university getting good ranking in that. So author's identification is also important. And Infibnet Center also created the site, the Indian Research Information Network System. So therefore we must create our profile on these various academic social media platform and Infibnet site. And that will help to make our research publication visible to all. This is all. Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice day and keep yourself safe from COVID-19 pandemic. At the end, I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Professor Susmita Chakrabarty, Madam, for giving me this opportunity to interact with you on the eve of celebration, glorious 75 years of Calcutta University and Department of Library and Information Science. So I feel proud myself to be part of this program lecture series. And thank you to all the participants for attending this program. Thank you so much. Thank you, madam.
Thank you very much, sir, for your elaborate presentation of higher learning and how it can be benefited through the social media tools and the digital repositories in several sectors, as well as some digital tools like Zotero and other things. I think our research scholars and young professionals, as well as veterans, will be very much benefited from using these repositories for their purpose. Now, after the prolonged deliberation of both of our speakers of today's program, we would like to request for questions. First question is by Shayantani Mondol. Sir, what is I index? Over to you, sir.
When your paper is cited by your 10 number, more than that paper is cited by 10 times by any research scholar, that is I index. And H index is also there. Your more than seven paper is having at least seven citations. Then it is a H index. And details, madam will elaborate on that impact factor and all. So it is your individual index. And from this, you would be able to understand that how much impact your research work is having. Thank you.
So another question I have in mind, I think not a question, but more like an elaboration I want from you, because we have many young scholars and students today. So if you could kindly elaborate on Zotero and Mendeley, because both of those are very much required. Sir, cannot hear you, sir. Your audio is off, I think.
Madam, for Zotero and Mendeley, these are two important sites. Although there are many reference management tool, but you can make your account either in Mendeley or in Zotero, and they are giving 2 GB data to you free of cost. If you want more data, you can procure the premium one. You can subscribe it so that you can get more data. So you can create your folder in this Mendeley or Zotero platform, and you may make different folder as per your research interest, and you search the paper in this Mendeley or Zotero, and you can club it, you can select it and keep in your folder. Whenever you want to write your review of literature, you go through the paper, you write, and there is a plugin facility, reference plugin. What plugin facility is there? If you put all the data and include this plugin facility, then automatically whatever reference you put in your review of literature, that will be listed in the form of bibliography. And you can also change it, maybe APA or Chicago or any style. There are thousands of style of reference management. You select as per your paper's requirement, your all the bibliographical details will be converted immediately into that. So that earlier in our day, what we do, we used to write references in catalog card, and we file it in alphabetical order, then we type in or handwritten, then type it on typewriter or later on computer, what file. And we make a PDF like this, and we also don't know at that time APA and other style. Whatever style our seniors we are following, we try to follow that particular style. So different university, different institution, they are having their own style. So, but this reference management software, they will save you a lot of time to manage your references, to manage your bibliography, all publication. If you complete your work, you can delete, you can create another folder, or you may download in your system. So only 2 GB data is available, and if you want more, you can procure.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much,
madam. You can organize separate. Some experts are there. Those who can take this session separately. I have also attended their session once in Bangladesh. They have conducted one reference management software. I also attended, and one of my friend, Dr. Manish Bajpayee from Lucknow, National Law University, Lucknow, and one of my friend, Dr. Pathak from ICER Bhopal. They are having good command over this reference management software. They can organize hands-on practice on that.
Yes.
You may invite them. Yes. Later.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Actually, we are going to have our conference in the month of November, and then we usually have tutorials and workshops along with our conferences. Some persons from the audience have asked for PPTs. For them, I have one just line to say that the video will be available for the whole program in
on YouTube,
in the YouTube channel. So you can use that video, and you can hear it again and again to clear all your doubts. Okay, and now it is the time for the last and the most important part of the program. These persons have come. This is the time for showing our gratitude towards them. So I will now ask Professor Aurobindo Maiti, a senior professor of our department. Before that, I want to introduce him with a few lines. He is a renowned professional as well as a professor in the field of library and information science. He has joined this profession in the year 1999 as an assistant librarian in the Central Library of University of Calcutta. Then in 2009, he has joined the teaching profession in the Calcutta University itself, in the Department of Library and Information Science. And now he is a full-fledged professor and doing so many research work. His students have been awarded MPhil and PhD. So many of his students already have been awarded. And he has written some books as well as so many articles and papers. And last but not the least, I want to add that he is one of the nicest human beings that I have known ever in our field. And he is truly a person for the students. Very student friendly, very hardworking, and very sincere person, which is very rare in these days and time. Thank you. Over to you, Professor Mike.
Sir, congratulations.
Okay. Good evening to everybody. Thank you, Susmita Madam. First of all, I want to tell that I am not a senior professor. In our department, so many senior professors are there. Professor Biplab Chakraborty, Professor P. Niskanti Panigrahi, and Professor Swapna Madam. Actually, they are the teachers of mine. So they are the senior most. I am not the senior. Okay. Now we are at the end of this program. So it is now giving the formal vote of thanks. At first, I convey my heartfelt thanks to our chief patron, Professor Sonali Chakraborty Banerjee Madam, the Vice Chancellor Madam of our university, and other patrons, Professor Ashish Kumar Chattopadhyay, Pro Vice Chancellor Academic Affairs, Professor Meenakshi Roy, Pro Vice Chancellor Business Affairs and Finance, Professor Devasis Das, the Honorable Register, for giving us the permission for conducting this type of event in our department. Then I convey my heartfelt thanks to our fellow colleagues, Professor Swapna Banerjee, Honorable Professor of our department and Honorable Dean of our faculty, Professor Pijiskanti Panigrahi, Professor of our department and also the Secretary of our faculty, Professor Biplab Chakraborty, Professor Dr. Sobhij Kumar Choudhury, Dr. Borkhil Mondol, Dr. Bijan Kumar Roy, Dr. Pubalika Bhattacharya Moitro, and Ms. Nikita Lama, the youngest colleague of our department. So I convey my heartfelt thanks to all of them. Now I convey my heartfelt thanks to the dignitaries, means the speakers of this seminar, Dr. S. Bhatt Memoni, Associate Professor, Library and Information Science, and also the Head of Research Group for Interdisciplinary Studies, Almak Tabatabai University, Iran. In her topics, Research Ethics and Plagiarism Prevention, she has already talked regarding the meaning of ethics, regarding the meaning of research, ethics in research, principles of research ethics, examples of immoral research behavior, plagiarism and its different causes, cultural factors affecting the plagiarisms, training factors of plagiarisms, educational factors of plagiarisms, social factors affecting plagiarisms, and also the economic factors. And different factors affecting the prevention of the plagiarism and different affecting factors and the root or error of different something. So I think through her lectures, we had delivered a lot. And I think all the participants who are observing, watching this YouTube channel and all the different participants, I think they also benefited a lot. Now I convey my heartfelt thanks to the another speaker, Professor Manoj Kumar Sinha, now the head of Department of Library Information Science and presently the Dean of the Swami Vivekananda School of Library Sciences, Assam University, Silchar. He has also delivered a topic, nice presentations on research visibility and the role of university and institutional libraries. Through his presentations, he delivered a lot regarding number of university libraries in our country, objectives and functions of different universities, functions of universities, higher education institutions, objectives and functions of college and university libraries, different ranking list of the university institutions based on different NAAC, NBA, time rankings and NIRF, and elaborately discussed on the role of college and university libraries in supporting access and research activities. He also pointed out, as an individual faculty member, what are our responsibilities? Why we should make our academic profiles and research outputs visible? Different internet access by the users, social media platforms, online platforms, and different academic and social media identifications of different sites and different methods, so that we can visible our academic profiles like Google Scholars, ResearchGate profiles, create profiles in LinkedIn, Google Blogs for sharing your profile, authors' identifications, authorship ID, and upload, and different referencing management tools. I think a lot of things he has already discussed through discussions, and I think many of us highly benefited through his lectures. So I convey my heartfelt thanks to Professor Manoj Kumar Sinha sir. I also convey my thanks to all the participants, without whom these programs, I think, can never be success. So I again give my heartfelt thanks to all of the participants for watching this video, for watching this YouTube, and attending these programs. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for extending your vote of thanks. I forget.
And last, I want to address Professor Susmita Chakraborty, the organizer of this seminar. I have already forgotten.
Madam, I forget to address, sir.
Yes, definitely.
Madam, welcome to.
Without her efficient effort, I think it's.
Now, over to Madam.
Over to Madam.
One problem we have, I know question answer session has ended and Thanksgiving have been done, but we have some enthusiasts have asked some questions right now. I would request Professor Sinha and also my fellow Professor Maiti to consider. Please, sir, answer these questions. Ghulam Jilani asks that how a librarian can play a role in combating the plagiarism. In short, because our time is over, but just brief answers. Okay, sir.
It is a very good question, because librarians are the person who are supporting the teaching learning activity of university or college. So librarian is a nodal officer of Infibnet, managing the Urkund software, he is creating the ID for all the faculty and researcher. So he is having advanced training how to check plagiarism, and so he can organize training while giving orientation to all the newcomers in the university or college, all the researcher. He should organize training program or orientation program and discuss the plagiarism issues, what types of plagiarisms are there, how we can reduce the plagiarism, and what type of software are available. Actually, UGC has given us through InfliNet the Urkun anti-plagiarism software, that is a very user-friendly plagiarism software. And there are many other commercial software like Turnitin and Grammarly. They are also doing
very good.
So librarian can librarian can help the scholar how to get reduce the plagiarism. So he can give formal training to them. Thank you.
And another
in
question
our university, I know that Dr. Soumit Sarkar, our university librarian, has also taken initiative for conducting such type of training regarding the targeting software. And so many research scholars and university students, they have already participated in that program.
Usually, librarian is the nodal officer, as sir has said, and all the research scholars' outputs have to be gone through that software in that institute before submission. And nowadays, most definitely. Of the universities are submitting their MPhil dissertations also through a plagiarism software. Now, Shekhar Modok asked another question: what is the difference between commercial reference management tool and free reference management tool? One difference is obvious.
Already mentioned.
Mentioned that up to 2 GB data, it is free. Mendeley and Zotero, up to 2 GB you can store. If it is beyond that, then you have to purchase the some amount will be required, and university can purchase on behalf of all the scholars and teachers, and the access can be given to all of us. So and if you do some free reference management tool other than Mendeley or Zotero, then there is a problem. You have to keep one page on that. They will check, give report, that will go to in their site, and you will also not having anything in your hand. So a structure report will be not given, only they will show grammar mistake and some. So but part you have to give. But in Urkun or I have gone to the plagiarism software, but in reference management, that is very
Zotero,
important.
Zotero, Mendeley, etc.
Zotero and Mendeley software, up to 2 GB data you can manage. If you want more, you can purchase, or you can delete your previous data. Suppose you have written the paper, you know, no longer want to keep that data with you, you can remove it, you can create another folder, you can download current paper of your related topic. So in this way, free, you can also manage.
And one line I will just want to add for Shekhar, that Microsoft Word, as you type in, there is a one reference management system inbuilt in Microsoft Word also, that you can use for APA and all other styles. And also another thing is that every commercial software, most of them will give you basic free trial, at least trial, and some basic services which is free. Upward you
have
want
to purchase,
go,
yes.
Then you have to
or your university should purchase or college should purchase.
Next question is Ambadas Kamble, indexing journal means what, and what is the criteria of indexing journals? Madam, will you please answer this? What is the meaning of indexing journals, and what is the criteria of indexing journal? Next question is a bit ambiguous, but still. Madam, can you hear me? What is indexing journals?
May I reply, madam? Indexing, actually, indexing journal is a secondary source of information that is based on the publication which appear in the primary source, means journal. Any article published in the journal, so indexing company, the publisher, they used to take the abstract and all detail of that particular article and make one index. So they use software also for indexing purpose. And Google Scholar is also one of the indexing site where you can create your profile, you can put your all paper there, they will generate index, or it will automatically take your paper if it is online available. So you can select, you can add in that. So criteria of, there are many publisher in indexing like Scopus, Web of Science. These are two very big and important indexing journal site, and they have a different criteria. So they see all the standard, whether journal is peer reviewed or not. Some, there are a lot of criteria. You can visit their site, you can see. On the basis of that, if you apply for indexing your journal in that particular database, they will see all the criteria and then accept. There are some fee also to become member of that indexing site. So if it is a Scopus index or Web of Science index, Science Citation, Social Science Citation index, then EGC consider it. It is in their care listed journal. If you publish in those journal, you will be awarded with the credit of points, and you can show in your appointment and promotion, etc. Now there are many earlier what only ISSN number journal or peer reviewed journal we consider. But now we are not considering it. Peer review up to old regulation, but in new regulation, all journals should be UGC care listed or into the first group like Scopus or Web of Science index journal listed. So that is the provision.
Yes, sir. And another line to add is the criteria for coverage. One thing is there, it is being told that developing countries are not being covered fairly. And that is the question of digitally rich, digitally poor, and the economy, etc., the walls and divisions between the first world, second world, third world kind of things. But we will not go into the economic details. Next question is special libraries in India use plagiarism tools like Turnitin or Urkund? Definitely Urkund, because it is free.
Actually, yeah. Urkund is procured by Infibnet UGC, and on behalf of all Indian universities, institution of higher learning, colleges, they are getting Urkund from Infibnet. For us, it is free, but Infibnet is paying money for on our behalf. Yeah. And Turnitin is a commercial software. They have huge amount of subscription fee. So although we are using Urkund, but in Urkund, suppose similarity index for language, maybe Bengali, Manipuri, that literature they do not cover. If you check, zero similarity index will come. But Turnitin, they have a Unicode facility, various language they can support. So that is a huge good software. We also procured Turnitin this year, and that required a lot of training by Turnitin people. And if you attend those training, you would find it comfortable to use. And their similarity is, they are more strict than Urkund. So suppose in Urkund, if you get 8% or 8 similarity index, maybe Turnitin you get 20, 30, like that. So they are more rigorous. They have bigger database than
Urkund. Yes, and also in case of Authenticator, I think the score will be high. Authenticator is
rather than standardization is necessary of the plagiarism software. So, madam, before we end, would you like to say one or two lines? Madam, hello, can you hear us? Your connection has a problem. Can you hear us now, madam? I think because the storm is raising even here in around us. So I think that this should be the end of our program. Before we tell all of you, the resource persons and our audience, goodbye, I would request every one of you to be present in the next lecture. Usually we will have it every 28th day of every month, because you know February usually has 28 days. So every 28th day of every month we are planning these lectures. Two persons who are really renowned in their field will speak on special subjects of your subjects of importance, and we will take your questions. That is the real necessity behind having these questions, having this interaction. And we are going to have a conference, or you can say international seminar of a grand scale to celebrate our 75 and more years of existence. So all of you are requested to attend our lecture programs as well as our seminar, which will be held with Yathlis. You know, Yathlis is the Library Information Science Teachers Association, Indian Association for Library Information Science Teachers. So we are proud to announce our collaboration this year with Yathlis to hold our international seminar in the month of November. We will say you goodbye for the time being.
Thank you so much.
Still, we
for inviting me.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks to all for attending.
Thank you. I declare the program closed now.
Thank you.